Hi guys, welcome back to Tutor Lab. As a professional YouTube channel, we've received many suggestions and advice every day. And many audiences are curious about how we can post 2 to 3 videos a week. Today, I'm going to answer this question. So if you're our old audience, you will be very familiar with this mini foldable shooting studio. There are so many products on the storage rack waiting to be taken apart.Back to the shooting studio, most products will be sent here and our photographer will use different tools to take them apart. In order to bring more videos to you as quickly as possible, here is one of the most chaotic corners in our studio. But anyway, next let's talk about what kind of tools we're using. When it comes to tear down, the first thing that comes to your mind must be screwdrivers, wrenches, etc. But as we all know, most chargers adopt ultrasonic welding.It's almost impossible for us to take it apart without damage. So except for the screwdriver and plier, we also have many spudgers in different size. Another common tool is the hammer. We have 3 different size. The largest one is used in our early videos, and the medium size is the most frequently used. This is a cull hammer. No, it should be like this.But if you want to be more efficient, the Dremel cutting machine and vise are the most economical option. The following tool is the heat gun, which can help you remove different PCB components. And the soldering iron is essential if you want to take apart something yourself. The wooden board can protect the desktop. We just want to destroy the charger shell instead of our desk. And then here are some small tools, such as Charger Lab customized ruler, a digital scale, and a vernier caliper.We can use it to check the charger's size, weight, and power density. As for the PowerZ testers, there is good news for everyone. The brand new KM002C is officially available on our Amazon US store. Feel free to check out the video description below. Finally, the camera we use is the full-frame Sony Alpha 7R. After introducing all the tools we're using, let's take apart the iMac power adapter. Firstly, let's measure its size.Due to the thick shell and high integration, the Apple product is the nightmare for our photographer. And then fix the power adapter on the vise and use the Dremel cutting machine to cut the shell. Use the spudger to pry along the gap. The reason why our photographer didn't wear protective gloves is because he has professional and rich experience in teardown, but we definitely don't recommend you to imitate it. Please take safety measures before doing it yourself.Another reason is that we do not want to damage the components inside, so we have to do it little by little and clean it up every time. Then we will show you this module from all directions, which is a nightmare. Because the charger is filled with silicon adhesives, we need to make sure all the information printed on the chip is clear, so we have to use the spudger and heat gun to clean it up, which can take more than an hour.After that, we will remove all the components and shoot them one by one. Some components need to be cleaned separately. The last step is the outro of our video. I believe everyone is familiar with it. After shooting, the entire module will be stored in a plastic bag, just in case. Well, that's how we tear down the charger. Every boy may like to take apart or assemble different toys or something else when they're a little kid. But when it becomes your profession,It requires high efficiency, rich product knowledge, and sufficient protection awareness. We strongly do not recommend that you take apart these things by yourself. The capacitors and lithium batteries have the risk of fire and explosion. Okay, that's all for today's video. Hope each of our videos can help you know more about power-related products. Your support is always our motivation. Feel free to leave your comments below and tell us your thoughts. See you in the next video.